By faith, many overcame. Hebrews 11 continues to record the stories of many people of faith. Some of them are named, but many of them are not named. But all of these people have one thing in common. They had faith in God to do whatever they were called to do. And we'll look at some of these people now. And this is a really long passage, Hebrews 11 verses 32 to 40. And I'm just going to read them in increments for us. So in verse 32, we read about Gideon, Barak, Samson, Jephthah. These are all judges. And we read about David, who is king, and Samuel, who's a prophet. And what's common among all these people? They all had different roles. They all did different things. But what's common is their faith in God. Their faith in God made them do all that they did, which pleased God. So what are some of the things that they did? They subdued kingdoms. They worked righteousness. They obtained promises. They stopped the mouths of lions. They quenched the violence of fire, escaped the edge of the sword, out of weaknesses were made strong, became valiant in battle, turned to flight the armies of the aliens. So just think about it. So many conquests, so many victories. And I'm sure today we probably cannot relate with many of these things because, you know, we're not engaged in war in this way. But there are other wars in our lives. We have wars of temptation. We have wars, to do with sickness. We're trying to overcome sickness. We have, we are warring against delays that the enemy brings in our lives. We are warring against so many other things that Satan schemes against us. And what can cause us to overcome is faith. Just the way, all these people have overcome by faith. Hebrews 11 mentions about many other people with no names. And they've done some amazing things as well. I'll just read a few things here. Verse 35, women received their dead raised to life again. Others were tortured, not accepting deliverance, that they might obtain a better resurrection. Still others had trial of mockings and scourgings, yes, and of chains and imprisonment. So just a few points here is that, even though people are not named, what makes them special is their faith. And also notice, it's not talking only about victories. It's talking about going through some trials. It's talking about going through difficult periods in life, going through tough seasons. And they were able to endure. Even for us to endure, we need faith on our part. And these people had that kind of faith, faith that helped them endure. God commends that. The last point that I want to make to us is in verse 39. And all these, having obtained a good testimony through faith, did not receive the promise. And verse 40, God having provided something better for us, that they should not be made perfect apart from us. Faith gave them a good testimony. Again, many of them did not see the fulfillment of the promise, and yet they had faith to endure. And that gave them a good testimony. Faith gives us a good testimony in God's sight. And faith causes us to overcome. Faith causes us to endure. Let's have faith in God. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you that, Lord, you've given us, Lord, a revelation that faith is what is important, Lord, in all our lives. Lord, whatever it is that you've called us to do, God, I pray that, Lord, we will move forward with faith. And Lord, especially those who are in a season of enduring things, I pray, Lord, for your extra grace upon them. And Lord, help them, O God, to rejoice in the fact that you still take notice of them, Lord, because they are enduring by faith. Thank you, Lord. Thank you once again. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.